want to talk a little bit about Ryan Tannehill. Why do you, is there a couple of factors as to why you feel like his interception rate has been so low since he's gotten here and become the starter?
Yeah, you know, I think he's been, you know, very decisive, makes good decisions, understands what we're trying to accomplish. You know, and I think he's done a really good job of just taking care of the ball. And, you know, we hope he continues to do that.
Is that something that guys a lot of times improve at the more they are in the league and see coverages and know where to go with the ball and where not to go? Or is it more of a just a that he's such a good fit for this system that everything just kind of works?
Yeah, you know, I think the more you play, Terry, you know, the more experience you get, the more comfort you have within the system that you're running, that you're a part of. There's a lot of factors that go into it, you know, your teammates and their abilities. And, you know, Ryan's done a good job of taking care of the ball, and we're going to need to continue to do that.
Jim?
Good morning, Pat.
Jim.
Wanted to ask you, I guess, about Deshaun Kizer, the new kid on the block. Just what's the process like in getting him as up to speed as you can? And does that transition from you working with him on the field to maybe him disappearing for a while as part of the COVID protocols? Or what do you envision happening there?
Yeah, you know, it's a combination of, you know, some on-field work and, you know, a lot of Zoom work. And just getting him up to speed. There's a little bit of familiarity that he has with the system based on his past. That's helped a little bit, but he's got a lot of ground to make up. And I think so far, you know, it's been good. And, you know, we'll continue to work with him.
But just his skill set, just from what you know about him and tape you've seen of him, what are your, I guess, just thoughts on what you have to work with there?
Well, you know, he's only, you know, not even been here maybe a week, but, you know, the skill set's there. You know, he's got arm talent, very good size. He's mobile. So far, his retention level has been good. And we'll continue to work with him and try to, you know, have him understand what we're trying to accomplish here.
John Glennon.
Hey, Pat. I know a lot of sacks last year given up by the Titans, and Ryan's a guy who's kind of traditionally been high and taking some sacks, but this year much different. Wondering how much role Ryan himself you think has played in lessening those sack numbers, and if he has played a role, you know, what is he maybe doing to help that?
Yeah, I think Ryan's done a good job of, you know, kind of knowing when the journey is over on a play and throwing the ball away. You know, that's something that he's done a little bit more this year. I think the other part of it is, you know, his teammates around him have played really well, you know. So I think it's a collective thing. I think part of it is him throwing the ball away and then, you know, the offensive line protecting and receivers running crisp routes and knowing what they're trying to do.
Sure. One other question. I guess you hear it said sometimes that the quarterback has to have that element of trust in the offensive line. When an offensive line changes like the Titans has this year, does that take a little bit of time to kind of reestablish that trust when the personnel changes due to injury?
No, I don't think so. I think there's an overall trust in our whole system and offensively what we're trying to do. I know Ryan trusts each and every one of those guys. And what we're trying to accomplish each week. And, you know, I really sincerely mean that. And, you know, next man up mentality, really.
Thank you.
Teron?
Good morning, Coach. This question is kind of off the regular path, but out of curiosity, is there anything that you guys do in that quarterback room just to kind of refresh yourselves mentally or just be able to reset each week?
Not really, Teron. I think, you know, we do have conversations, sometimes non-football conversations, trying to, when we reacclimate for the next day or next week, but then we quickly get, you know, back to work. I think, you know, we like to have fun with what we do. You know, it's obviously a high stress position and job, but, we try to work hard and have fun doing it. and keep everything in perspective. But there's nothing really too interesting to really give you right there, Teron.
Okay, the reason why I asked is because I know Ryan is into a lot of the mental, like, resetting and kind of the holistic side of things. So I was just curious if that surfaced in the quarterback room.
Yeah, I think Ryan has his own routine that he does. That's sort of a solo thing with him. As far as collectively, no, we don't really have that in our room. It's more of just a collaboration and just kind of getting back together each week.
No Phil Jackson Zen meetings, huh?
I wish I had something better for you, Teron.
Yeah, no, it's all good. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
Paul?
Hey, Pat. I'm just wondering, you put in so much work with Trevor, I imagine, as the kind of designated survivor. What was it like? Was there a moment when he left where you kind of exhaled at everything that went into that? And what's it like to restart that process with Kaiser?
No, it's fine. You know, personally, you know, I was happy for him, but also sad to see him go because Trevor's such a good guy. And the relationship that he and I built was kind of unique because it was so much of what we're doing right now and kind of working around the fringes of what we were doing and keeping him up to speed, not only with what the plan was each week, but logistically. And also he was, you know, awaiting the birth of his son, you know, so there was a lot of moving parts there. So on a personal note, you know, bittersweet. But other than that, you just reset as a professional, you know, what's next. And that's what you have to do. And Deshaun's here now. It's essentially the same type of thing going on with Deshaun and just getting him up to speed.
So are you with a couple select receivers and you just kind of have a socially distanced workout when he comes in the evening after practice?
Yeah, there's a session that we have kind of put that back on coach how he wants to talk about that or not talk about that. But we do have a plan for Deshaun mentally and physically for him. But I'd rather, like, if you want to ask that question, just put it back on Mike.
I got you. Thanks.
Thanks, Paul.
Terry?
Pat, based on, I guess, the situation that the Broncos had, what do you get? Who is your emergency quarterback, and how familiar is that guy with the concepts? How often do they drop into quarterback meetings or anything like that if that situation ever arose?
You mean other than Deshaun?
Yes.
Oh, well, there's, you know, each week it's different. I mean, you've already seen three other quarterbacks play this year. You saw Cam Batson play quarterback last week. You saw Derek play quarterback. So you've seen Logan play quarterback. So each week it changes. You know, there's opportunities there, you know, to do a lot of different things. And you've seen it, you know, in games. But each week the emergency quarterback changes, honestly. And, you know, you have a window of plays for that person.